Belghecham. He's been a professional for only 8 of his 35 years. He's averaged only 3 fights a year. 4 of those he won by KO in his 19 wins, 1 draw and 3 defeats. But he's never been stopped. Tough man. Seen and done a lot. And there's a well-lived-in fish, you might say. Background, North Africa. Arabic, North Africa. Belghecham. Of his 23 fights, 22 of them have taken place in France. At which stage we hand to Mike Goodall for the main event star.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to welcome your local hero,
drawing the crowds again. Only that one nuisance defeat to Vera on his card. But it's a great CV for a man who has brought style to the game, both as an amateur and as a professional. Silver medalist at the World Junior Championships in Cuba in 2002, and after that, Irish senior champion 2003, 2004, and 2005. And then he went to the Olympic Games in Athens, and then he became a professional. First pro fight, March 2006. It seems that first fight was in the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, where he spent a lot of his recent professional life. One man missing from that entourage tonight of Andy Lee's is Manny Stewart. Emmanuel Stewart has been this corner whenever we've seen him as a pro, but tonight Emmanuel Stewart is actually commentating upon that wonderful top of the bill fight in Las Vegas between Manny Pacquiao and Miguel Cotto. One of Ireland's idols, Andy Lee. Beard or no beard. Great fighter. Has been in great form over the last couple of days. Relaxed, but not cocky. Suitably on his guard and ready to go. The big fight is nigh, and we go back to Mike Goodall.
Ladies and gentlemen, can I ask you please all to be upstanding in respect of both national anthems. First of all, the national anthem of France.
Thank you.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of Ireland to be sung by Brian Hartnett.
Sheena, Sheena, fall at off the yawligeren. We not slow at hinder on the gone. Favour hesse, shantira sheen shar fasta. Ni og for fentir on of entral and of the hymns of Hanabwil legyan and wimpan was no sel legon as trip telong na vile shalik hanik
Ladies and gentlemen, the officials appointed for this contest by the Boxing Union of Ireland, the timekeeper, Mr. Alex McKenzie, and when the action begins, the third man in the ring this evening, our referee, Mr. Emil Teat. Ladies and gentlemen, this is tonight's Big Fight Live! Ladies and gentlemen, tonight on RTE Sports, live and exclusive from the University Arena here in the fabulous city of Limerick, Brian Peters proudly presents tonight's main event, sponsored by Yaojing Beer in association with Tipperary Water and Finch's, who present an international contest of 10 3-minute rounds in a match weight at 11 stone 8 pound. Between and introducing the boxers, and firstly, fighting out of the blue corner. He wears the black trunks, two-way gold, comes from Lyon in France, weighing in at 11 stone 6.5 pound, and comes to the ring with a 23-fight professional record, consisting of 19 wins, 4 wins by way of knockout, with 1 draw and 3 losses. He's the French middleweight champion and the middleweight champion of Europe. Please welcome Affif Belghecham. And across the ring, fighting out on the red corner, wearing the red trunks trimmed with gold and blue. He weighed in at 11 stone, 8 pound. Comes with a 25 professional record consisting of 19 wins, 14 wins by way of knockout with 1 loss. As an amateur, he was the Irish middleweight champion on 3 occasions and won a silver medal at the World Junior Championships. He's the super middleweight champion of all Ireland. Ladies and gentlemen, presenting Limerick's favourite son, Limerick's Andy.
The referee, Mr. Emil Teat, will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
10 good rounds, keep it clean, keep it professional all the time.
Good stuff, keep it clean, keep it professional. You know all about it, Philip. Spoke to you in the dressing room, Emil Teat's final words.
10 3-minute rounds.
10 rounds, it's scheduled for. Of course, 3 minutes a round as usual. Huge height advantage and presumably reach advantage as well for Andy Lee. The bell and round one. A pair of southpaws. Notice the tightly held guard of Belghecham and the long looser of Andy Lee. Andy a boxer, pure and simple. And the shout from the ring side is, take your time, Andy. Good jab, good strong jab. He's a very strong right hand, which I certainly referred to pretty heavily before the contest. So far, we haven't seen a single punch thrown by the Frenchman. It's nice and calm from Lee. That's a good start. That's all he wants. Just jab. The jab serves two purposes. You can get through and open the road for the left, or it can keep the man at distance, whichever your choice. So far, not a punch has been thrown by the Frenchman, and we've been boxing for 1 minute. Now that's strange, to say the least.
I think what he wants to do, he's trying to find out how much power Andy Lee really has, and he can tell by the way the punches are being delivered, or the way they're landing on the gloves and on the arms, so he knows now there's a bit of power. You can see the way he's being very, very, very careful. Like, he's tucking up well, the guard, you know, the hands are up well, the arms are tucked in tight. He doesn't want to get hurt, he doesn't want to get tagged at all. His defence is so tight right now, you couldn't get water through it.
And all the time he's watching him, that left hand of Lee's is cocked. And you've got to think that Belghecham is thinking, that's the left hand, it's ready and waiting, and it goes. Tries to get through, he's sparing with it, Andy Lee, so far. But no doubt the first minute and three quarters of the fight has been Lee's. He's been dictating it, not with any great punch technique in a sense, but that was a good left hand to the body, and that certainly lifted the elbows from the abdomen. Don't get involved in a fight, as the advice been shouted at Andy Lee. Just take your time, do your boxing, do what you're good at, and good at it he is. We're in the last minute now of the first round.
You see the way Belghecham there, he was snatching the punches there. It meant he was trying to get the punch out as quick as what he could, and back as quick as what he could, because he's worried about getting tagged with a real good left hand or right handed body or to the head. So he's been very, very, in fact, he's been far too careful. But Andy Lee's really good, solid punches are getting through. Even though they're hitting the arms and the gloves, there's still, there's power there. And Belghecham, he knows there's power there. And that's why he is still very worried.
Yes, he went slightly off balance there when he received one of those from Lee. And Lee, at this level, at this range, can absolutely dictate this fight. There's no doubt about that. At this range, if he keeps this guy at distance, then the road is clear for Andy Lee. But a long way to go, still another 9 rounds. That one belongs to Andy Lee. In the corner with Andy this evening, as we watch the final few shots of the round, Dave.
Yeah, so it's textbook stuff here for me. Long range, he doesn't want to get involved in the brawl. You shouldn't move in too close to a short man, because that's when you suit his tactics down to the ground. The way Belghecham's throwing punches, he's snatching, he's worried, you see, because he can feel the power in Lee's punches. Even when they're hitting the arms and the gloves, there's still power there.
In the corner with Andy is Joey Gamache, a two-weight world champion. Way back in, well, not all that long ago, 91, 92. And also in there, just outside the ropes, is Roger Lee, Andy's brother.
10 seconds.
That's Joey Gamache with a nicely trimmed beard. He was a super featherweight and lightweight champion of the world.
Round two.
It's round two between Andy Lee and Affif Belghecham. First round, well nigh perfect by Lee. I know there's always a temptation to get involved, but he's keeping it. Watch him, he's just at the end of that. Like buffers in a railway line, he's just keeping the guy away on the right hand. Left hand is cocked, and so far, nothing of consequence from the Frenchman.
But for Andy to get some of those good strong punches through and to get on the target, Jimmy, he has to make sure that Belghecham opens up, because Belghecham's so tight right now with his defense that it's hard to get air through, never mind water, or water never mind air. But Andy has to let him get into a bit of a brawl here, so as Belghecham throws some punches, because he's thrown absolutely nothing and he's leaving himself, he's so tight, he's like a drum now, he's not leaving himself open at all. So Andy has to make sure, he has to try and prise that defence open or do something to lead Belghecham into a false sense of security to make sure, or so as Belghecham tries to offload some of his own punches in order for Andy to get his through.
That's the voice of Dave Boy McCauley with his assessment, and we're only in the second round. We're a minute and a quarter into the second round. and it's a fight that so far has been dictated to the end of the right lead of Andy Lee. Both men lead with the right, although you wouldn't believe it, because Belghecham is leading with neither hand at the moment. He's just standing there trying to keep the guard tight, as Dave Boy McCauley says. It's airtight, it's watertight, but it may not be fist tight. Still, that right hand goes out of Andy Lee. Don't have to be scoring, because they keep the man at bay all the time. He hits out, made a move. Nicely evaded by Lee. You would hardly believe that these two men were coming in more or less at the same weight division. There's the height of Lee, and there's not an excess out from him. Jab, jab, occasional left hand. Another left, nice one to the body. That got underneath the elbow of Belghecham, and they're in the last minute of the second round. You can imagine what Lee was like in his pomp as an amateur. No wonder he got silver medal in Cuba way back in 2001, wasn't it? And 2002, rather. Because he had five fights in those World Juniors, and nearly all of them were knockouts or stoppages. He was just beaten in the final by a very good Cuban. And this is the sort of style at which he boxed. The length, the reach, boxing from afar. Jabbing out the right hand, occasionally scoring with a well-timed left hand. There's a right to the body from Lee, it was a good one. And he's on his feet, he's on his toes. Immediately moves away as the bell is very much on the scene. Round two, so far, in a 10-rounder, it's Lee.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that. But we've seen Belghecham there beginning to open up a wee bit, and this is what we need more. Because the more he opens up, the more chance Andy Lee has of getting his own shots home himself. Because, as I keep saying, that was a cracking left up to the body there, but we need Belghecham to open up a wee bit more so as Lee can get the punches through the gloves and under the elbows. Because this man's defence is watertight. And it's not a very exciting fight to watch right now, because Belghecham is being too negative. He's coming forward, but he's doing absolutely nothing.
Let's screen the two men in contention. Much more talkative Frenchman. Is Andy's been all over the place fighting, particularly in America, Indiana, Connecticut, Nevada, New York, Tennessee, and then back in Europe, in Germany, and of course here in Limerick, and at the National Stadium in Dublin, and at the O2, and always he brings his skills with him, and they are considerable. European Union champion is Belghecham. Matthew Macklin on a panel tonight is the European champion. Ah, that's that right hand going in, the more or less decoy with the left. That right hand carries a lot of venom from Lee. So far he's boxed perfectly to orders. This is what his advisors would be telling him. This is what Joey Gamache, the two-weight world champion in his corner, would be telling him. And all they have to have is confidence in Lee, because he has massive confidence in himself.
What I would do if I was Andy Lee right now, I would try and go for the body that wee bit more, because it's easier to get under that short rib. Because up top, Belghecham's guard is watertight, but you can see gaps there below the elbows, and that's where Andy Lee wants it. And if he can't get below the elbows, bring him around the back of the elbows, because you're still hitting the target, and that wears you down. This is what he's going to have to try and do. Instead of going for the head too much, go a wee bit more for the body.
Beware in case you're making bets. This man, Belghecham, generally starts on the rather slow side and holds his better stuff for the latter half of a fight. So just remember that. That's an important thing to bring into consideration in this one. Matthew Macklin, who's on our panel tonight, may be on a double mission, working for us as an assessor and analyst commentator, but also having a very close inside look at Lee, because that may be upcoming in the relatively near future.
And what he wants to do is now, when he has Belghecham on the ropes, take one step around and then bang a left hook or a right hand into the body. But if he's standing too straight, he can't get them on target. You have to take one step to the side and bang to the left, and one step to the right, and then bang to the right. And that's when you get right behind the elbow. There's no point in getting under the elbow because there's nothing there bar his side. You want to get in behind the elbow.
Had to stay in favourably. He's boxed with a lot of consideration, calmness, and assurance. And he has not got involved in anything that slightly resembles a rumble.
That was a good solid left to the body. He got it in right round the back of the elbow. And this is what he has to try and do, because that's where Belghecham, that's where he's vulnerable.
End of another round, another good one for Andy Lee. The last shot he threw in the round was an excellent left hook to the body.
Great stuff from Andy Lee here. Look, he's throwing hooks and he's throwing right hands. He's doing great stuff. He's keeping Belghecham at arm's length and not getting too involved in a brawl, but he had to try and entice Belghecham to throw some punches so he can whip them in below the elbows. But see here, there's a bit of a gap there, and that, it must take one step to his left and bang a left hook in. He does it sometimes, and sometimes he doesn't, but he's going to have to do it more often, especially when he gets Belghecham on the ropes.
You know you're French, you know what they're talking about. Lee is early off his stool. Nice sign, ready for action. He just simply wants more of it. He meets Belghecham halfway across the ring, or a little more than. And many times he's thrown out that jab. One after another, one after another. He's won the first three rounds. And he still hasn't thrown his big bombs, Andy. Belghecham admits to being a slow starter. He says, wait till I get revved up in the closing stages of the fight. And now he's beginning to say, time I made some move. He wants to get inside, because inside he is a real, real danger. A left hand went across there, and you saw it on the jaw of Lee. And it was just a little sample of what Belghecham probably could do. Well, Lee is not for turning like that. That right jab is persistent and consistent.
See, Belghecham's beginning to change his tactics now, Jim. He's coming forward now, beginning to offload some bombs, but he's a smaller target than Lee. He's a smaller man than Lee, so it's very hard for Lee, you know, to hit him and bang on target. So what Lee's going to have to do is instead of poking that jab out, try and drive it right through Belghecham and let him know who the boss is. And when he lets those right hands and left hands go at long range, throw them out hard. Don't do it all the time, but bang, two or three or four good solid shots just to let Belghecham know that you're still the boss and you're still in control. So he's getting a wee bit more confident now. He's coming forward and beginning to unload his own bombs himself.
Which is a kind of saying to Andy Lee, look, I'm still here, still game, and you haven't really battered me up in any way, despite all the punches you've thrown. Most of them, of course, just right jabs. Andy still with the left hand cocked, the left hand at rest, ready to go if an opening presents itself.
You see, Andy's still going a wee bit too much. He should crouch down a wee bit and take one, as I keep saying, take just one half step to the side, whatever side it may be, left or right, and bang a left or a right hand into the body. But you can get in around the back of Belghecham's elbow, and that's where he has to be to get under that short rib.
With the height advantage at the moment, be a disadvantage to...
It is a bit of a disadvantage, but I can see the gap. I'm sure Andy Lee can see the gap. Just bend the knees slightly and take a half step to the left or right and bang it in. And he will hit the target every time, because Belghecham lifts that elbow a wee bit too high, and it gives you that opportunity to get that punch delivered properly.
Very interesting fight. Two completely different styles of the both southpaws. And Lee ducks, doesn't have to weave too much, but gets away. And another round is coming to its conclusion, with Lee still in charge. very much in charge, although that was a better round for the Frenchman. And there's just four rounds gone, six still scheduled, and still they keep shouting at relax, relax, relax. And around the ring, they're dead right about that.
Yeah, it's the same stuff. But you can see that was a good left hand by a Belgium. He's coming forward now, he's beginning to overhand right and overhand left and round the corner stuff. So Belgium's trying to rough Andy Lee up here. So what Andy Lee has to do is get back onto his boxing skills, keeping it long range, but when he's throwing those right jabs and those left hands across, make sure he throws them with a bit of power. So this man stands back and says, gee, that was a really good shot there, a good solid shot.
And the music playing in the PA and the general ambience of the place. I don't know if you can hear whatever Joey Gamache is saying in the corner, but it's got to be positive. And it's round five. 3 minutes to halfway.
What Andy has to do is right now is back this man up. Both good solid right jabs and good solid straight left. Just to let this man know I'm still in charge here. Belgium was coming forward and doing his own thing. Andy Lee had to pump the shots in, pump them in hard, just like that.
That's
let him go. I'm still here.
Good stuff from Lee. A smile, a big, endearing smile. That's hardly the way that Belghecham looks at it. Endearment maybe too costly at this stage, but the crowd now encouraging Andy. And this I don't like. I like it in one sense, but it may encourage him to get into a fight. And into a fight means he'd be encouraging Belghecham.
What Lee wants to do is what I said, Jimmy, keep it at long range. And he doesn't need to throw everyone as a bomb. See right now, let him go easy, just do what he's doing. But every so often you have to bang him in hard and bang him in fours and fives at a time. But he's doing the right thing. But if you do it too often, you tire yourself out too quickly. But he has to let this man know, I'm the boss, and I've got the power, and I'm going to keep you at bay.
Whatever he's doing anyway, he's encouraging the crowd in this magnificently appointed university arena at Limerick University. With a snappy right, snappy left hook. Didn't quite reach its target, that right hand did, but it was slipping across the face of Belghecham rather than staying for a moment and saying hello. There's a left to the
body,
and that certainly was felt by his opponent. That took him slightly off balance, but the ropes were there. Somebody desperately trying to make contact with Lee. But in this noise, you need a seance to get through to him. But they're trying to say, box careful, and it's good advice, whoever's giving it. I can't see, somewhere behind me. Belghecham has nobody shouting any advice to him. Lee just sticks out that rigid right arm of his.
See, right now is the time, Jimmy, to bang in a few good solid punches, a good hard left, a good hard right. Belghecham right now, he's open close. You can see the gap under the elbows, and the gloves are beginning to get a wee bit looser in around the face. So now's the time, jump on him now and punish him.
And he's getting a bit more anxious by the looks of things, Belghecham.
And he's getting a wee bit more rugged.
This is the halfway mark, and it's a round in which Andy Lee has finally, in this particular fight, dictated that he is, on this night in Limerick, the boss. That's after five rounds.
Good stuff again here from Andy Lee. He's in charge all the time. He doesn't want to get too involved or too close. He's doing the right thing. But he wants to make sure when he throws those body shots to take, as I keep saying, all it takes is one half step to the left or to the right, and bang, he'll hit the target 100% on. But he's not doing that. He's standing too square on, and he can't get the hooks round behind the elbows. So a lot of the shots that he's throwing around here are hitting the elbows and hitting the gloves and the arms. Yeah.
Let's slip into Lee's corner. What are we talking about?
I'm getting lazy in front of him.
One of the beers I said earlier on is Joey Gamache. And he looks calm, doesn't he? Looks like a man in control. But this game is fighting, this game is punching. And this game is one where one punch can end it all. Either way. No doubt Lee is ahead. In my opinion, 5 rounds ahead. Three right jabs, one left. Left again.
A lot of Lee's jabs aren't getting through, Jimmy, but they're making Belghecham, they're making him think.
And he can't make a move himself.
Yeah, you know, and this is what it's all about. You know, this is a game of chess also. You know, you have to keep your opponent thinking, because while they're thinking, they're not throwing punches. And he's trying to work his way around that jab, and he doesn't really know what to do. So Andy Lee's doing the perfect thing here, keeping this man at arm's length, keeping that big left jab going out, and keeping those big left hands coming over the top.
The moment is as though Belghecham was hanging and was a punch bag, because he hasn't responded at all. No one hit the heavy bag, it never hits you back. I thought, as Dave Boy McCauley said, the guard was just widening a little bit in Belghecham. Which either means he's getting tired, his concentration may be slightly gone, or he may be just a little more anxious than he would like to pretend he is, because he's now at the part of the fight when he likes to come forward and dictate, and that's more or less his history. Although he's 35 years old, that's massive in living experience on this earth, but he's only had, this is his 24th fight, so it's very little really in terms of fighting when you consider that Andy Lee is 10 years younger and he's in his 21st fight tonight as a pro. That was a nice left by Lee to the body there. Wouldn't you get fed up boxing Andy Lee, because that right arm is coming out. How long is it? And how long is it going to stay there? Couple of good shots there from Lee again. Belghecham. Another right to the body from, or left to the body from Lee. The right hand doesn't connect, but it keeps Belghecham in his cage. I'm sure you can hear that voice in the audience here. Big audience it is too, despite all the counter-attractions. Live and on television, still people have tuned in here to the UL tonight to see the local man Andy Lee boxing the European Union champion and boxing with the style that we've come to associate with Andrew Lee.
Great stuff with Lee again. It's been the same thing the whole way through, round after round after round. He's doing the right thing, he's doing it perfectly. He's keeping Belghecham at arm's length, keeping him at long reach, banging across his own rights and his own left. It's not a terribly exciting fight, but Andy Lee's doing the right thing in order to win the fight, and that's the most important thing of all.
The background, status quo, rocking all over the world. And certainly Andy Lee is rocking tonight.
Seconds out, round seven.
Round seven in the offing. And as if there was no seam at all in it, Andy Lee continues with the right jab. Some of them are getting through, most are taking on the gloves, but all of them are keeping Belghecham, a very silent and quiet man, at the other side of those punches. And all the time are waiting for one big explosive left hand maybe from Lee. He hasn't thrown it too often in this contest, and you could say if you're counting points, he doesn't need to. Just quicker to the punch, longer of reach. Seen a lot of Lee's fights as an amateur, and so indeed has the boys on the panel, particularly Mick Dowling, who's traveled with him. And you know, he's been, at that time as an amateur, he was excellent. Can you think of any amateur who'd be able to run? Look at him. But as a pros, that Zira defeat seemed to haunt him for a while, but he's obviously got rid of it now and has exorcised any pain, mental or physical, from that. One and three quarter minutes left in the round. Now the crowd are getting a little anxious. And the more anxious they get, the more Andy will try to please them. Maybe, I hope not. Just keep doing what he's doing. Maybe the advice of Dave by McCauley is right. Maybe the occasional big bomb in between all these fancy jabs. But if he gets involved in trying to please the crowd, some of the crowd all of the time, or all of the crowd some of the time, it's just not on. A man behind me says it's easy, Andy, and it'll be hard to argue with that man from what we've seen so far. There's a minute to go in this seventh round. Every time you jab move, seems to be the mantra.
Every so often, Andy Lee wants to land a big bomb. Andy Lee has a bit of power. Seemingly he's jabbing out to get, he has his reach, regardless of whether it goes through the gloves or hits the gloves or whatever. He said, let it go, so as to remind Belghecham that there's still loads of power there, and I can still knock you out, providing if I get the opportunity or if I get the opening. This is what he has to do. He can't tap all the time, because then Belghecham, he will go in confidence.
That's the first exchange we've had for a while. Inside the last quarter minute. Last few seconds now. Again finishes with a threesome there, Andy Lee. And he walks back to his corner, a little more tired looking than he was, but far from being exhausted.
Great stuff again from Andy. As I keep saying, it's the same thing the whole way through. There's no change. He's doing everything perfectly. Just keep doing what he's doing, and he's gonna win this fight tonight.
What's Joey Gamash saying to him?
This guy's open for everything. Let me tell you. Keep picking up that jab. Let your hands go. Beautiful. You don't belong in there.
He's a calm guy. I've met Joey the last couple of days. Nice man, say that about him. He is calm on the corner. And I don't know about you, what you were like in your time, Dave Boyd. Did you like a fellow who's as calm as that?
That's what you need, because if he's calm, everybody's calm. That's the main thing.
Seconds out, round eight.
Three rounds remain. In the University Arena, Limerick UL. Lee winning it. Of that, there cannot be any question. So now, all that remains to be seen, if it's going to be a points victory, or is it going to be an inside the distance victory? If it's to be the latter, that's the only way that Belghecham can win. Which means there are two ways that Andy Lee can. Not a bad bet to have with three rounds to go. Straight left. Right down the avenue. It's really good stuff from Lee. People like a bit of a brawl, a bit of a fight, a bit of a bang up. But they also like the man to win. And that's what Lee is on his route to now.
We all love brawls, I mean, we all love to see exciting fights, but sometimes you have to do what you have to do. And what Andy Lee's doing right now is exactly what he has to do to keep this man at long range. As I have said, it's not terribly exciting, but at the end of the day, the most important thing is, as long as when the fight's over, you're sticking your hand up. You know, that's very important. So therefore, keep doing what he's doing. and keep this man at the end of that big long jab, and I can't see any reason why his hand shouldn't be stuck up. Because in my book, he's won every round so far.
It's an amazing length of arm. And have it long, tucked to the end of it. And be able to throw it consistently and consistently. And indeed, if anything now, the most tired limb of anybody in this arena is that right hand of Andy Lee's. He's thrown out dozens of times. Head, body, and a lot of them taken on the arms and gloves, which are tiring for Lee as well. But don't forget, if you constantly hit on the arms, as indeed Belghecham has been happening to, they're going to get tired too, and you're going to have dead arms. Well, maybe not tonight, but tomorrow. Lee just moving enough, first right, then left, then straight on, then moves away. Once he keeps it at distance, there's no way, but no way, that Belghecham can win the fight at distance. But still, the corner of Belghecham is saying, get inside, don't mess about, get inside, force the fight. That's what the corner's been saying to him. In French and Arabic and any other language you care to tell me about. But at the end of another round with two to go, it's Lee's night so far. But there's still 6 minutes of fighting to go. But don't give your money away in a silly bet.
Good stuff again from Lee. He took a wee step to the side there and banged that right hook. And this is what I want to see him doing more of. And in my eyes tonight, he hasn't been doing that often enough. He's been throwing hooks, but he hasn't been taking that wee extra step to the side and banging them in round, getting in behind the elbow. And that's what he has to do. That's how you knock the wind out of their sails. But in saying that, we can't be crew critical because he's doing everything that he has to do. He's winning the fight right now by a mile in points. Therefore, nobody can be too harsh on him.
Affif Belghecham finally made 11-6 and a half yesterday. I think he might have had a bit of trouble making weight. The other voice you heard there now is Andy's brother, Roger Lee. But the reason that Andy got into boxing in the first place, he used to see his brothers boxing, and they encouraged him and inspired him. And he certainly lived up to his own aspirations. What a pity that Vera decision has marred his card, because his CV is very good. Another left hand underneath the elbow, and that one got through. Corner of the Belghecham, still very anxious. They want him to get inside there and do what he did in the DVDs I've been watching in the last few days in all of his opponents. Certainly against Mosmola and Chiruta. He was right inside, certainly in the last five rounds. That took away, and once he gets inside, he's a vicious left-hand hooker to the body. But as you can see for yourselves, Lee not allowing him that latitude. But a good guard, you've got to say. It's like he's protecting your precious family heirloom, Delph. But if the Delph falls on the floor, it will most assuredly crack.
The sort of guard you want your front door, because he'll let nobody in. You know, he's not letting any punches through at all. His defense is unbelievable. Like, Andy Lee has landed a really good, clean, solid shot. I mean, a one-punch knockout shot, as we know Andy Lee has. He hasn't landed one good, clean shot on him tonight, because Belghecham's defense is so watertight.
You wouldn't need guard dogs around that house of yours, Dave.
No. Well, this guy will do fine.
He's getting a bit closer now. For the first time in the fight, Belghecham fancies himself in close. But most of his work tonight is at the end of that jab of Lee's. He's got to trust himself to get in all that. Must be hurting him at times. Lee wants to step aside and get out of that now. And the break just works its business. Watch his head. The head's taken care of now. As you can see, it's only 45 seconds to the end of the penultimate round.
Oh, that was a cracking left hand by Belghecham. Right over the top. That's what Anthony has to be careful about. He's getting too close.
He's getting too close.
And he's dropping his right hand.
That's the sort of punch that the European Union champion is well capable of. The same when I was looking at those DVDs of him, saying to myself, Lee, I wish you could see this, don't let him inside, because his left hook is a cracker. They're getting a little too close for comfort now, but they're only 10 seconds to the end of the round, and then Andy back to his corner, where they'll admonish him slightly, and the bell will go presently, and there's one round left in the fight. There's the best punch that Belghecham has thrown in the whole fight. And he waited until the end of the ninth round to do it.
See, Andy drops that right hand right down, Jimmy, and the next thing is bang, overcomes Belghecham's left hook. Cracking punch. You know, if he had been throwing that punch sooner, you know, he could have done a lot more damage, but he didn't get the chance. But Andy Lee had to make sure and keep that right hand up for this round, because Belghecham's still a bit dangerous.
Fight in Limerick. Andy Lee will most assuredly go up the rankings. Belghecham has brought his reputation here to Limerick, and Andy Lee was all about bursting at asunder, if you can do such a thing. Now Lee is back to his former up on his toes style, jabbing the right hand, move left, move right, stop for a second, throw a punch, move again. And the time keeps eking away. 2.5 minutes left.
What he has to do is he has to keep moving to his own left, stay out of Belghecham's left-hand range. If he keeps moving to his own right, he's in trouble. But he has to keep coming left to stay out of danger. Because if he comes left, Belghecham can't get the big left hook on.
And as a southpaw, he'll know that himself. The crowd, undoubtedly, well, they're hardly going to be shouting, Affif, Affif. They're shouting, Andy. That's a good-looking left hook, but it's short a distance. He has it in his armory, all right.
There it is again. He's moving the wrong way. He had to keep moving to his own left. If he does stop moving to his right, there's a real good chance this guy can put him down, because that's a pretty strong, potent left hook. And every time he throws it, Andy Lee's jaws at the end of it.
We're in the last round. We have a minute and 37 seconds to go. And sooner or later, you have to get into the rumble. Lee trying to appease the fans. And now he's in the danger zone. He's in the very place where this man can hook dangerously. It's a fight stoppage maneuver that Belghecham has, and it's something that Andy Lee must avoid. Goodness me, after a half an hour of fighting, he must know now. Don't get involved. Just over a minute left. Great finish. If the crowd wanted a bit of excitement, they're most surely getting it now. Belghecham showing that he's a good fighter. Maybe more than a good fighter. Lee, left, right, left, right. Keeps Belghecham at bay. Lee switch getting there for a moment. He went orthodox with a left lead. There's a half a minute left and less now.
See, I don't understand what Andy Lee's doing. There he got tagged again. He's moving right into the danger zone, moving left. He should be moving to his own left, out of the way. He has to hang on.
The crowd begging Andy Lee to move. Keep moving. Don't move to your own left. If you're going to your own right.
Oh, my word.
Nearly took him out. Lee is hanging on. He's going to hear a familiar sound. There it is. It's all over. And Belghecham came back fantastically, because for the first 76-7 rounds, he was out-jabbed, out-pointed by Andy Lee. And the smiling Limerick man knows he was in a real fight. There's no doubt about that. That was an absolute cracker at the end. Belghecham, who must have absorbed a million punches. I know we exaggerate to make the point, but he came back fabulously in those last couple of rounds. I guess he'll be the most surprised man in European Union land if he gets the decision. But I think if he gets the decision, they'll need to re-roof the university arena here in Limerick. But with some great boxing by Andy Lee, and in the end, some great fighting from Andy Lee. Young people, many of whom you think might be in bed at this hour, shouting for Andy. Brian Peters in there, the promoter. Andy Lee comes over to our side of the ring to accept the sound plaudits of the crowd. Then he goes over as fighters always seem to do.
Yeah, you are very, very good boxer. Good luck for the future.
Same to you.
Thank you very much. Ah, yes.
Mike Goodall.
Ladies and gentlemen, at the end of 10 fine rounds of boxing, the referee's scorecard reads Affif Belghecham, 92 points. Andy Lee, 99 points. The winner, Limerick's Andy Lee.
You heard Belghecham saying to Lee in English, in perfect English.
Ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for Francis.
He would have had to mean every
Belghecham.
Bit of it. Brilliant stuff from Lee. In many ways, a boxing lesson in the old time meaning of the affair. But in the end, the Frenchman showed what a battler he is, what a heart he has, and he's 35 years old, 10 years Andy Lee's senior. But Andy Lee, in the first 7-8 rounds of that fight, give what I think is a masterclass. Okay, you want excitement, go and see rodeo or bullfighting. But for Andy Lee, for me, that was a valuable lesson in how to jab, how to follow up, and all of those things. And presently we shall hear Andy talking to Joanne Gadwell.
Well, Andy, congratulations. A great win in the end, but I have to say, I think you gave a lot of this crowd a bit of heart failure in the final round.
Yeah, I knew he was going to come on strong. It seemed like after about the 4th, 5th round, he was just kind of holding back, just waiting for a big finish. So I just braced myself. I made it look worse than it was, I think. I was a bit too negative, but yeah, it was good. I knew he was strong. He hit me some good shots, so I had to give him respect.
It was a fight up until that final round that you just seemed to control round after round.
Yeah, he was very hard to get a rhythm with. He was very defensive and I couldn't really get no boxing rhythm. It was like I was doing all the work and he was just staying tight in his shell. But I was hitting him with some good shots and clean shots and I didn't put a dent in him. So I said I better just keep it nice and handy in box because he's going the distance. That was it.
Yeah, it must have been very frustrating because he had his defence so tight throughout the entire match, and we could hear everybody from the outside shouting at you, just relax, take your time, but that must have been so frustrating.
It's hard because you want to put on a good show for the fans, you know, people come out and put on their pay the money, but it's hard when you know what I mean. I was doing all the work and trying to create a fight, but he was being very defensive. But he did a good job silencing the crowd and making it was very quiet. I couldn't believe it, like at times, but at times they got behind me and I could hear him, Andy Lee, it was great. Thank you very much for everything. All week it's been fantastic, all week, all over the city, people wishing me well and taking photos and kids and all, and it's amazing the interest and the support I get, and I thank everybody, and thanks all very much, and may you continue.
Was it difficult there when you were going through the rounds, and as you said, it was very difficult trying to get through to him, and were you thinking about, because you were obviously winning the fight by so much, that you were looking to get that land, that big one?
I wanted to finish the show, you know, like get a knockout, but I knew it wasn't there. And sometimes if you go looking for it, especially with him coming on strong in the last round, I could have, you know, risked winning the fight. So I just said I'd box Mark, get a 10-round decision, 10 good rounds of boxing. And I just want to thank Joey Gamash and my brother Roger for all the training they gave me over the last month. It's been fantastic. I mean, that was like, I did 10 rounds there. I could have done another 10. It was great training. Thanks very much, Joey and Roger. And Brian Peters, putting on a good show as always. Tomas Rohan, Damien McCann, RTE and Yajing Beer for everything, so making this happen. And all the people of Limerick, thanks very much. You're well on.
Well, you certainly gave them a great show. Let's bring Joey in. Joey, was this a more mature Andy Lee performance tonight?
It is, yeah. You know, Andy's arrived. You know, he's here. He was a technician tonight. Like I was telling him in the corner, you're putting on a clinic. I mean, he boxed well with the jab. It was an educated left hand, and the guy couldn't do anything. The guy had a lot of heart. And don't forget, this is the European Union champion. That's a good status, and the guy had a great record, a 20-3. And Andy, he's not fighting any easy guys. It's a great step forward in our career.
How was your heart after the final round?
I know how Andy is. Andy wants to give excitement, you know. He did the technical work and says, okay, now I'm going to give him something else. So you can't stop Andy from being Andy.
Well, we have to ask you a question about the future of Andy. I know we have Matthew Macklin up in our studio there. Is a fight with Matthew and his European crown on the line?
No. I mean, we're in different directions. And, you know, if it happens, it happens. But right now we're going to enjoy a break and see what Brian's got lined up for us.
Well, we all enjoyed Andy Lee and his performance tonight. Thank you to you, Joey Gamache, and thank you, of course, to Andy Lee. Of course, it wasn't just about Andy tonight. We had Affif Belghecham as well. Well done. It was. I'm sure you felt unlucky in the end because you came so close in that final round.
C'est clair que déjà je dois remercier. Les Irlandais, le public irlandais.
I'd like to thank you, the Irish public.
Parce que c'est une terre d'accueil, je n'oublierai pas de le dire en France, je le savais, mais c'est confirmé.
It's a friendly, they're friendly people in a land of welcoming people.
C'est important de le signaler.
It's important to note that he felt really welcomed here in Ireland.
Ensuite, je voulais dire que Andy Lee, il m'a beaucoup gêné par rapport à son placement. J'ai eu un peu d'appréhension parce que.
Andy Lee disturbed him from his placement on the ring. And his position on the ring.
J'ai eu un peu d'appréhension. Et je pense que si j'avais écrit un peu plus en méchant, c'est que j'avais su le cadrer un petit peu avant. Je pense que le combat il aurait pris une autre tournure parce que sur la fin, je l'ai bien bousculé.
He was a bit fearful at the start and staying on his position. But if he'd believed more in himself, he could have maybe disturbed Andy Lee a bit more. Because towards the end, he could move him.
Je regrette de ne pas avoir essayé d'enclencher ça avant. Mais j'espère que ça me servira d'expérience.
He regrets that he didn't fight earlier, but that's going to help him and be an experience for him for the future.
Well, it was a great experience for everybody here tonight. Thank you very much to Affif Belghecham.
Okay, well, there you go. Andy Lee has won, but he did give us a few little heart palpitations in the ninth round and then in the tenth round, Mick. And as Belghecham said there, just the regret about him not coming out and fighting earlier, because we were chatting here, it was like as if he'd come for a score draw in the first five rounds.
Well, indeed, Dara, you know, it wasn't the best fight we've seen, that's for sure. But you would have to agree that Andy Lee fought the perfect fight. And he did give us some little bit of heart failure there in the 10th round. But I think from Belghecham's point of view, you cannot win a fight if you come and you're negative and you're defensive all the time. The whole trick about boxing is you've got to score punches. You cannot come out and just have a negative defense all the time. And yes, he did stop Andy Lee from landing a lot of punches. But the thing is, he landed absolutely nothing himself until round 9. And the scoring showed that he ended up... He leveled the ninth round and he won the 10th round, but that was all. He was far too negative.
Yeah, no, I think it's hard for Andy in a fight like that to really shine. You know, he won easy. He won every round up until the ninth and the 10th. Probably a lack of concentration in the last round. Probably switched off a little bit, knowing he had the fight won. I think with guys like that, you need to put sort of 3, 4, 5 punch combinations together because they're always going to block single shots and 2 punch combinations. You need to throw, you know, punches in bunches to get through the defence. But Andy don't really have to do, but he's a lot better than that. But you're never going to shine against guys that are that negative, you know, that defensive minded. You know, you're just not. Andy Lee's a counter puncher. He needs people to throw punches.
It was actually quite hard to watch.
Yeah.
You know, I can only imagine for you guys what it's been like in the past to be in the ring against fellas like that, because they're just pulling your hair out.